Okay, welcome to another Wild Art session. This week we're going to have a go at doing a sort of fantasy space scene with a big planet and the Milky Way and a galaxy effect and some mountains in the foreground as well. So a number of elements and hopefully quite a few new techniques and skills that we will explore with that. Okay, so for today's session we'll need that bit of card that's sort of roughly A4, A5 and just used bran flakes. So any cereal box. Another strip of card, so again maybe just sort of the side of a cereal box. Something circular to draw around, so a roll of tape or a mug or something of this kind of size roughly. Bit of sponge. I'm gonna do some sponging in the background. Scissors to cut out one little thing. Pencil to do a little bit of pencil work. Medium-sized brush, whatever you've got. I like using a flattened brush myself, but whatever you've got to hand, something roughly half a centimeter to a centimeter across should be fine for this. You might need, if you've got a bigger brush, you might need maybe some pencil crayons or something sort of slightly finer, like some Posca pens to do a bit of the detail. Pot of water, and then palette-wise, we're going to need, so this is my very messy artist's palette, some black, so quite a lot of black, quite a lot of blue, and then a bit of red and a bit of white, and that should do the job. Okay, let's give this a whirl. Whew. Okay, I'm going to start with just the black, and I'm going to just dip my sponge in the water, and that's just going to help it move just a little bit more fluidly. So let's get that decent amount of that black and just sponge away. Sponge for all you're worth. And get it well spread out, because the more you spread out the paint, the quicker it will dry. Let's get a bit more. And bring it right, we want it to come right down. And all the way up, across. Okay, fill in all those little gaps. We want decent coverage so that it's proper block of black, and as you can quite imagine, this is going to take a little while to dry, but that's all good. We've got a couple of little things we're going to do in the meantime, and goes without saying that you could have a bit of a break and get yourself geared up for it, and I don't know, have a nice drink of something. Okay, that's pretty much full coverage, I do believe, so let's leave that there for now, and that just needs to dry for, I don't know, could be 5-10 minutes. Okay, on that second strip of card we're going to draw the outline of a mountain range. So let's go from the left and let's just start low down, do some nice jagged mountain tops. Come along, maybe there's a bit of a ridge there, and then let's come up in the middle to a great big impressive central mountain peak, and then down again, and then maybe one more slightly smaller one heading off this side, and then a nice ridge down, something like that. Okay, right, once you're happy with it, of course you can change your mind a few times, but let's cut that out. That's that cut out, so it's this piece that I want, the actual sort of solid mountain range itself, and we're going to be using this along the base of our space scene. We're going to be putting it in place, I'll show you in a moment, and then sponging around it to get a silhouette outline of our mountain range. Okay, in a few moments we'll go back to the main bit of card once that's dry. Okay, this is pretty much dry now, so I'm going to start the sort of the transition of tone in the background. I think it's the right time to do that. So let's bring in our cutout of that mountain outline, of that mountain range. You want to bring it right down to the bottom of your bit of card. Now, if you guys would like to stick it down there with blue tack, for example, that might not be a bad idea to make sure it just sort of stays in place while you do the rest of the sponging work around it. I think I'm comfortable enough just to hold mine in place, but I would say blue tack's not a bad idea at all. Okay, I'm going to take some of the blue, and maybe a little bit of the black. Okay. Right, let's see how this goes. So, hold it in place and just sponge around, and we're going to be... So, initially, hold it well in place and just sponge all the way along that mountain range outline, just as low down to it as you possibly can, really. So start, yeah, just following that line along the whole range. Okay, once we're done with that, and I think that's okay what I've got there, we're gonna just sponge a next layer above it. And by using the same sponge, so I should have said that, sorry, use the same sponge as you did with the black, slowly but surely our paint should transition back across towards the black as the blue runs out on the sponge. So I'm just doing another layer coming up there, and I think I'm going to just sort of fade out now further up. Okay, that's about right. I think that's, yeah, that should do it. Okay, let's see how that's looking. We're going to do a little bit more, it's looking pretty good, detail in these mountains, but probably not till the very end of the process. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to do a couple more quick things now. So the first of those is bring in that circular thing, and we'll go top left, so slightly above where all your blue is, but I think not quite to the very edge of the card. And I think this is going to be our main planet, kind of our main feature in the whole thing. Fairly Jupiter-esque in terms of its patterns when it comes to it. So just draw around that. Okay, happy with that. Right, once that's done, I want you to go into it and probably starting top left, just do an arc with your pencil. So a slightly curved line like that, if you can see that. Okay, come down and parallel to that, so again slightly arced, come across again. It's up to you how arced you go, but what I'm doing there is probably about right. Okay, same again below, slightly arced all the way across. Maybe you want to go slightly more arced than I'm going here. Okay, I'm going to do maybe a slightly thinner one, just to mix it up. And then one last one at the bottom. So all the arcs follow the same line as one another. They're all parallel to one another. Okay, I reckon that will do. Right, the last thing I'm going to do with the pencil is just identify where I'm going to do the sun rising over this. And I've been trying to think where we should do it. It's a bit of a tricky one. But I think actually let's do something a bit more interesting. Let's have the sun coming down here. So I'm just going to do a little mark there to mark where the sun's going to be rising up. Ultimately, you could watch this whole thing and decide that you want your sun to be rising elsewhere. Once you've seen how it all unfolds, but I think, yeah, for now I'm deciding to put mine there. Right, very quickly, now that I've defined where my planet is, I'm going to take that sponge with the blue again, and I'm just going to do a little bit more sponging of a diagonal out from sort of the middle of the bit of card and out to the top right. And this will be our Milky Way rising out from the horizon. So just a line. So I'm kind of using the edge of the sponge actually to do this. Slightly wider in the middle, heading up to the top. Okay, something like that. Probably that's good enough. And we'll be doing some more detail of stars into that a bit later on. We'll do the highlights later on. Okay, we're just going to do an initial bit of shine of the sun around the planet. So I'm going to take some of the blue, and we will be lightening this up towards the end. But just to begin with, take a little bit of that blue, mix in a little bit of water, just a touch, a few drips, wipe off the excess. Okay, so we need something straight. Could be a ruler, could just be another bit of card, whatever comes to hand. We're going to start, so I've got my point where the sun is rising. I'll wipe off a bit more of that excess, actually. I'm being a bit more cautious here than sometimes I would be, but always good to start cautious and then be more bold rather than be too bold too soon. Right, so from that central point, I'm gonna do an initial radiating line. I'm gonna do that sort of the top end first. Okay, so from there, bring your bit of card around at an angle and make sure it keeps coming back to that central point. So we're doing it from top to bottom so we're not smudging through our lines. Okay. So I keep coming back to that central point. Right, you can see at the moment I'm not going all the way down. I'm just gonna, actually I might start coming out from the central point. And just to, let's say, around there, so not all the way down to the horizon. And slightly more with that one. Okay. So it's quite tricky, but just, I'd say, take your time with it. There's no rush, better to get it right. Okay, I think that's about right. Yeah, let's leave that there for now. Okay, so with that same blue, I want you to go from that point and we're going to outline the whole of our planet with that blue. Now, this is the sort of stage and element where if you rather, you could do this with a pencil crayon or like a Posca pen, that kind of thing, if you feel it would help you to be a little bit more accurate. But don't worry, I mean, you can see I'm not being brilliantly accurate myself, and it doesn't matter. With art, so often, I feel, it's the overall impression that matters, not the tiny little details, and that's why I love mural painting in particular, because mural painting is all about the overall impression, and it's much less about all the tiny little details. I think as long as you get the right impression, you're onto a pretty good thing. And it's just really generally good not to fuss too much, because fussing generally causes stress. I used to find that, I used to get stressed all the time. Okay, right, I'm just gonna use the blue and come out into a few of my lines, just a little bit more, but just part way. Okay. Talking about not fussing. Okay, that'll do for now. Okay, now we're going to do alternating colours in the different strips. So I'm going to start with just the blue. Might mix in a little bit of black just to make it a little bit more interesting. Okay, that's good. Okay, where to start? Let's start, I'm gonna start with the second strip down, so I'm gonna keep within this strip. Basically, what you're wanting to do is squiggles and lines in just a whole array of different directions. You have license to squiggle. So what I'm gonna do first, actually, and what Jupiter has, is a little bit of a sort of spiral, and I might do a few spirals going through this. So start in the middle and you can go out and around, but don't go beyond the edge of the pencil line that you've done just yet. So I might just do that. Okay, once I get here, you do that and then, yeah, just squiggles with leaving some of the background in between those squiggles. So you can see that I'm making sure that I'm not just doing a block of detail. I'm leaving some of the background showing to show that there's texture and detail on this planet. Okay, as I come over here, Need to change it up. Okay, I'm going to change the direction. Sometimes what you might want to do with your squiggles is just do something further out, and then you'll know how you need to sort of do the details between it and the other area. So you could do something over here and something here, and then you'll know that you need to sort of join the two areas with a certain direction of squiggle slowly coming together. Okay. Right, that will do for that. Okay, let's refuel on the paint a little bit. Right, skip a strip, and we'll come down to this one. Let's start over here and do another sort of spiral type thing over here. And then, like I was talking about, let's do something else over here that helps us to decide how we're gonna bring the two bits of detail together. So, line back and forth. We start coming out this way with that one. Okay, I do that, and then something kind of coming into the middle. I've been really pleased to see you guys using different mediums, so by all means try this with any medium that you like. So I've seen pencil, crayon, and pastels, watercolors. That was really cool. Okay, skip a strip, and let's come down and let's do this last one. And, don't know. Like you can see, it really doesn't matter too much what you're doing. As long as you're doing squiggles and you're leaving little gaps between them, that's all that really matters. We're kind of getting the texture on the planet. Okay, we'll leave that bit there. I'm going to wash off my brush, and I'm going to make a new and different colour. So I'm going to bring in a bit of my red. Let's bring that down there, and then the blue, because I think I don't want it to be full red. I think I want this to be sort of purplish. Okay, hopefully that's about right, but the only way to know is to test. So often with painting, you mix something up, just test it first. You're not committed. You don't have to then use it for the whole of that section or period of time. Change it. Okay, let's have a look. So I think I'm going to do a big, it's probably about right for this layer. Okay, a big sort of storm area initially with this colour. So I'm doing, Jupiter, you know, just I think has the one main storm on its surface, the eye, as it looks like, but this is a fantasy scene in a fantasy planet, so yeah, it doesn't matter what we do. Okay, I'm going to do some squiggles more in this direction over here. Kind of have to meet those a little bit. So you can overlap up into your blue a little bit with these lower squiggle areas. Yeah, like I say, as long as you're leaving some little gaps in between, the rest really doesn't matter. Okay. Squiggle over here, squiggle over there, squiggle, squiggle, everywhere. Okay, do this strip up here. Do a spot there. Got an epic version of, I think, Clair de Lune just starting in the background, which was used in one of the Godzilla films. I know the films aren't fantastic, but the music's pretty cool. Okay, let's finish up by doing this area down here. Maybe one more spiral, just because the spirals look quite good, I think. Okay, we're getting there, we're getting there, we're getting somewhere. Cool. Okay, right, we're going to lighten up the bottom left-hand side a bit more because that's where the sun's rising and so more light is hitting that side. So let's go back to our bluish tone colour. Let's mix in a little bit of white, a bit less of the black. Okay, as ever, a little bit of water, otherwise it will get all thick and sticky, thicky and sticky. We don't want that. Sometimes you do with painting, and some artists would tell you, oh yeah, you know, you want the paint nice and thick, but it depends on the approach you're using and what you're trying to achieve, and I think often for me, I mix in a bit of water just because it gives more precision and the paint moves in a, I think, more satisfying way, but everyone will tell you something different. Okay, let's start with this strip again, and let's just go to the sort of the far left, and we're going to go basically over our squiggles. Don't worry about going precisely over. So starting at the left, and we're going to just probably, should we head up to, tricky, maybe around there. So maybe sort of roughly halfway with that. And then with a couple, just come slightly down into your second area with those, because we're going to do a little bit of sort of blending, and then maybe just slightly up as well. Just a teeny touch. Okay, that'll do. Right, let's come down to the second area, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to sort of slightly overlap with the sections above and below, but just come to maybe halfway across that strip. And yeah, these lines, I'm kind of going over what I've done, but if I'm missing it by a touch, doesn't matter. If you can manage to leave a little bit of that, the black, that would be great to maintain that texture. But more than anything, just don't stress. Okay, same with this bottom stretch as well. Let's just come to sort of partway along. And then I might just bring that line, while I'm using this blue, I might just bring that line around a little bit. Whatever you do though, just avoid getting the side of your finger in some wet paint. Easily done. Right, okay, we'll leave that. And we're gonna do the exact same with the more pinkish, purplish area. Okay, mixing in some white to what I had already used. Okay, hopefully that's about right. Okay, making sure you're not dragging your finger through any wet paint. Let's start at the top. And let's just go over some of the squiggles. Roughly kind of halfway. Just going to come into some of my blue. So I've used the blue to go into some of my red purple, and I'm going to use the purple to come a little way into some of the blue. So that it means in the end the two areas are somewhat distinct, but not too harsh a distinction between them. So like if this is sort of swirling storms on the surface of this planet, they're slightly swirling into one another. Okay, put it about right for that one. Come down to the next one. If your lines are a lot thicker than mine, that's no bad thing. Often a sort of a bolder approach can really work, I think really be effective. And with all these tutorials, I'm wanting you to do your thing. I mean, guided by the instructions and tutorial, but basically I want to see your approach and your style, not just an exact replica of my own. Okay, cool. We'll leave that there, I think, that element, and wash off the brush. Okay, while we've got this sort of purplish colour mixed up, let's go back into that. Maybe it's a little bit too vibrant, so I'm mixing in a little bit of the blue. Bring it back towards more of a sort of bluish purple. You get such a range of purples. Purple isn't just purple. Purple is a million different things depending on colours that are mixed in there. Okay, we're going to do a little bit, just a really little bit of highlighting on our mountain scape. Okay, so let's start at the left. And what I mentioned, I think, before is that you always want to be thinking about where your light source is, and that's how to make things 3D, is to think about where the light is coming from, and therefore where your highlights are and where your shadows are as well. So our light is coming from here, so we need that to be our reference. So all the light that's hitting the mountains, is it going to be on the left or the right? Well, it's going to be on the left. Okay, so let's come up with a little bit of mountain texture, probably not coming right to the very top, so we maintain a little bit of a crispness not Christmas, to the edge of the mountain. Okay, do that. And then that bit's in shadow, but then we'll come up here, way to the top. Be down a little bit. This is similar. If you've done the Hogwarts tutorial, this is a similar idea to that idea. We all make mistakes. Okay, so I reckon the light's beginning to hit again around there. So let's do a little bit there. This is where less is more. So be fairly sparing with your details. We'll come up to the very top here. You can see I'm just doing sort of basically quite wobbly lines. And I'm leaving plenty of the black, because these mountains are still mostly silhouetted. There's just a little bit of light hitting them. Right, the angle is such here that maybe only a tiny bit hits there. Just a teeny, teeny bit. Maybe the angle is such that we've got a little bit hitting there. So keep referring back to where your light source is. It's always good in any picture, I think, to have a light source, or at least to imagine where the light source is, and therefore how you can make things look 3D. Right, I reckon that's about it. You know, we don't want to overdo this. Maybe there's just a little bit of a ridge coming up there as well. Okay, right, we're going to lighten that up just a touch, and very little on the brush, and just want to think where a few slightly lighter bits might be. So maybe that edge, just pretty much the top left edges of the mountains. That's where it's going to be brightest. So yeah, it's not as simple as just where does the light fall. It's also a matter of where is the light falling the brightest. Where are your absolute brightest highlights? Once you start to think this way, then you're starting to think like an artist. Where you can be not just copying something, you can really be using your mind to decide how something should look. Okay, let's leave that. Okay, we're going to do a few bits of detail now, and a few stars, and a bit more detail in the sun rising there, or whatever it is, it's some kind of star. This is a point where if you want to, and you have one, you can switch to a smaller brush, finer brush. I'm going to keep using the bigger one to show that it can be done. You could also switch to the pencil crayons. That would be no bad thing at all. Okay, we're going to mix up a nice light blue. So this will be maybe 50-50, the blue and some white. To wipe off some excess on my brush, actually. Often the brush gets really kind of clogged up with paint, and you just need to slow right down and wash it off. Start again. Okay, with that colour, I'll do a few things. So I'm going to do just a few little bits of the sun rising into my lines here. So even less than I'd done before. And at the end, we're going to put the sun itself at the center of all that. Okay, that will do. And brush is a bit dry, so let's maybe just come round that edge of the planet again a little bit more to show that that's got the sun rising over it. Maybe that central one, because often when you see a bright light, the central line is really coming out. So maybe along your central line, just bring that out a little bit more with that light blue. Okay, cool, that will do there. Right, we're going to do some stars now. So to start with, we're going to do a few crosses like we did with the Hogwarts one. Might do a really big cross up here. And actually, I might make this one, so do another cross in the middle of it. So that will just make it look really bright, like it's really shining. Yeah, the cross initially, and then the dot on top makes the star look like it's twinkling, which is quite nice to have a few that are like that. Yeah, so we don't want to do too many. Another case where, in a way at least, less is more. And you get sort of a more natural scene if you don't do too many like that. Okay, yeah, let's leave that there. Okay, with the same blue, we're going to do a few little dots. Okay, I need to water up a little bit. Coming up into our Milky Way. Let's start a bit further down, actually, right at the horizon. So these can be fairly randomly placed. Some bigger, some smaller. Don't worry if they're exactly dots or not. You can see I'm sort of leaving a darker strip in the middle, so I'm going to do a bit over and a bit below. And that's how the Milky Way kind of is. There is this darker strip in the middle that does have its own stars within it, but it's a lower density of stars. If you guys want to try this, by all means, have a go at the splatter effect. I don't know whether I dare have a go because it can get messy. So I think I'm going to keep going with the dots. And this is when I'm doing a mural, even though it's really painstaking, I do stick with the dot, dot, dot approach just to maintain that control over where my stars are going. Okay, that's basically it. I'm just going to do that lower line coming up a little bit further. But yeah, can be getting a bit more sparse. Okay. Maybe just one or two further out. But as you get further out from the Milky Way, there's just a few little dots. We want that real density of stars to be just in the Milky Way itself. Okay, cool. Right. I think we're ready to switch to the white to do our final highlights. So let's get some of that, mix in just a little bit of water, but not too much, just a drop. Wipe off the excess. Okay, first things first, we're gonna just do that edge of the planet again. And a little bit more there, just to show that that's where the sun itself is rising. Just bring a tiny bit of that up into these lines. Okay, right, I'm going to take a bit more white. So I just want this to be really, really bright. Bring that down and in. So that can be a little bit of a sort of a hump of white coming up that side. Okay, with our white, let's go and do our dots into the center of our brighter stars. Okay, that's all the brighter ones. Okay, again, making sure you're not going to drag through any of your paint. Let's just do a few brighter stars in the Milky Way. Not too many. Maybe a few down at the horizon as well. Get some brighter bits into that lighter blue down there. So one bright one into the darkness of the Milky Way there. Okay, just a couple more. Right. I reckon that's our lot. If I'm going to do anything, I'm just going to do a tiny bit more lightness again around just this edge of the planet. This is the final fiddle. Okay, let's leave that there. Okay, well, as usual, I'd love to see what you guys come up with, and I'd love to see your efforts, particularly if you've done something a bit different here. So by all means, use different colors in the planet. You know, it can be golds and silvers, or it could be greens and blues. That could look quite good. Maybe you want to do a different horizon, so it could be that, okay, we've got the mountains, But maybe there's a castle in there somewhere as well that you've incorporated into your silhouette. Maybe if you're feeling ambitious, you could do a spaceship somewhere up here. You could always outline that with pencil first and then just do it with, let's say, pencil crayons. So yeah, if you're adding features like that, try and think about your composition. So we've got something there, we've got that. So perhaps your spaceship would be, yeah, in this area down here, or perhaps up here. But I think down here would work, coming up towards that, the planet. So, and you could do sort of a jet stream behind it. Yeah, have a think about what you could add to this to make it yet more exciting as a fantasy scene. Okay, well, all the best with it, and really look forward to seeing what you come up with. And I'll be doing another tutorial again next week. And I won't say what it's going to be because I often change my mind. So I'll just have a think and see what comes out next week. Okay, hope you're all doing well, and speak to you soon. Okay, bye.